then everything is there. Okay, coming to expenses and incomes, as I told you, when we are preparing the accounting equation, then expenses and incomes are adjusted from the capital account. Incomes are added to the capital and expenses are subtracted from the amount of capital. Now, under expenses, if the expenses are paid, then we directly subtract them from the capital account. But there can be two more categories of expenses. One is outstanding expense and one is prepaid expense. Outstanding expense is expense which is due but has not been paid and hence is a liability for the business. On the other hand, prepaid expense kya hai? Pre-pay kar diya, advance mein pay kar diya. Okay, so this is something which is not due but has been paid in advance, and any advance payment against which you will receive service in the future is a prepaid expense for the business, and hence it is an asset for the business. This is what we discussed yesterday. Now, just opposite cases we have in incomes also. The first category of income, again, income is from the perspective of business. So say the business has made any investment in shares of another company, so dividend will be an income, or interest if invested in debentures of another company, interest will be an income. So incomes again can be of two types: when not received on time. First category here is incomes which are due but not received. Okay, so income which is due but not received. This is known as, can anyone tell me what is this income known as? If it is due but not received, what is the term used in accounting?
Ma'am, prepaid.
Outstanding.
Outstanding income we use karte. Aur kya term hoti hai? Prepaid income.
Pending.
Haan?
Pending. Pending.
You nahi use karte. There's a typical term which is used. Yes, Gautam.
Outstanding. Accrued, ma'am. Accrued.
Accrued. Very good. Very good. Is known as accrued income. That is income which is due. The business has earned this income but has not received this income. It is still due from the other party. So iske against services business de chuka hai, ye paisa business ke paas future mein aayega, so this becomes an asset for the business. Okay, second is prepaid income. प्रीपेड इनकम क्या होगी? आपको हमारे बिजनेस को, से वी आर अ डिश ऑपरेटर, वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग दीज केबल सर्विसेज, एंड फॉर दैट वी हैव रिसीव्ड द ईयरली सब्सक्रिप्शन इन एडवांस. ओके, सो दिस बिकम्स अ प्रीपेड इनकम, बट वी डोंट यूज द टर्म प्रीपेड, वी यूज द टर्म इनकम रिसीव्ड in advance. अब पैसा पहले मिल गया, सर्विसेज अभी आपकी ड्यू है, आपने सर्विसेज देनी है अभी, तो अभी आप पे रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है टू रेंडर दीज सर्विसेज. सो फॉर बिजनेस, इनकम रिसीव्ड इन एडवांस इज अ लाइबिलिटी. ओके, सिंपल रीजनिंग, सिंपल लॉजिक. You have received some money in advance. You have the responsibility of providing services against that. So this becomes a liability. There is some income which you have earned but not received. Okay, so say for example, today is 4th and I have not received my salary for previous month. Then for me, that is accrued income because I have given services for previous month, but I have not received the money. So that is an asset for me. Kyunki future mein ye paisa mere paas aayega. Okay, so please have a look at all the four terms which we have learned here, because we'll be using them a lot. So if there's any doubt, any question, please ask. These terms should be very clear to each one of you. Okay, then I'll proceed with the question which we were solving. Let's move back to that question. Okay, so this was where we left. Yes.
Ma'am, can we go back to the last slide?
Yeah, sure. Yes, beta.
Ma'am, in the fourth part, you said income received in advance is liability.
Mm-hmm.
I get that it becomes a liability, but I'm not getting the exact reason. Because in accounting, if we only take into account the monetary aspect, then mm-hmm. we don't have a financial responsibility to make a payment or something.
जो बिजनेस होता है वो ट्रस्ट पे होता है. ओके, यही एग्जाम्पल ले लेते हैं इंश्योरेंस वाला से. आपकी इंश्योरेंस कंपनी है और आपने यही सेम डेट पे रिसीव करा है प्रीमियम.
ओके मैम,
आई एम टेकिंग द सेम एग्जाम्पल. सो अगेन इन दिस केस यू हैव रिसीव्ड 6 months premium for this yes, financial sir. Year and 6 months for the next financial okay. year. So you cannot yes, escape sir. That liability in yes, the next ma'am. Year. So that is yes, what I mean by this.
Okay. Ma'am.
Okay.
Got
okay.
it. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, so we move back to the example we were solving. So now you can attempt both the entries. One is of outstanding expense. And one is of insurance paid in advance, which is a prepaid expense. So I'll solve this entry with you. So when salaries are outstanding, it means the business has to make a payment but has not yet made a payment. So this becomes a liability for the business. So outstanding expenses आप liabilities के अंडर एक और liability creditors के साथ. creditors हमारे I think zero हो गए थे. so under liabilities you will add outstanding expenses 1500. okay, again this is in nature of expense, so this will also be subtracted from capital. So under capital you will reduce 1500 and again you will get the total as 204,100. okay, so please make this entry updated there. Okay, after this, your total again tallies at 204,100, and then we make this entry, insurance paid in advance. So this is prepaid expense. Now, this prepaid expense will be an asset for the business. You will add one more asset under the left hand side of the equation, which will be prepaid expense, and you add 300 there. Okay, now this expense is related to the next year and it has been paid in cash. So the second effect under this entry will be that your cash reduces by rupees 300. I repeat myself, your assets are increasing by 300, but under assets your cash is also reducing by 300. So the dual effect of this entry is like this. Your total will again tally. Okay, so after this we are left with few entries. So please complete this and we move to the next entry. So there are four entries there on your screens. Cash withdrawn for personal use, which is known as drawings, as I told you. These are drawings. Drawing. Then depreciation, sale of goods on credit, and rent due to landlord. Again, this is an outstanding expense. So take 5 minutes, try and make these entries, and then we'll discuss them. Okay, so class, let's discuss the entries one by one. We'll start with the 12th entry. Neha. Yes, Neha, are you here? Neha, not here. Priyanka, Vinay, okay, Vansh, you start with this entry.
Yes, sir. I mean, in the 12th one, we'll subtract 1200 from for cash under assets.
Yes.
And then we'll also subtract from capital rupees 1200 for equity.
Okay, good. So drawings is a personal expense for the owner. Now, since the owner has withdrawn 1200 in cash, we reduce the cash balance by 1200, and this is also in the nature for the time being. Understand, 1200 is a kind of expense reduction in capital. रिडक्शन इन इक्विटी जो ओनर ने कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करा है अपनी ही कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन से उसने 1200 विड्रॉ कर लिया है तो आप कैपिटल को रिड्यूस करोगे बाय 1200 और ये विड्रॉल कैश का हुआ है तो बिजनेस में कैश बैलेंस भी 1200 से कम हो गया है. ओके, सो वन इफेक्ट विल बी ऑन दी लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. Under assets, you are reducing cash by 1200, and one is on the right hand side, you are showing the effect in the capital account. Yes, Sahil, what is not clear in this?
Ma'am, capital mein minus 1200 kyun hua, samajh nahi aaya.
Capital beta, drawings kya hai? Owner पैसा विड्रॉ कर रहा है बिजनेस से पर वो बिजनेस पर्पस से नहीं है वो पर्सनल यूज के लिए है. ओनर जो पैसा बिजनेस में लाता है उसको कैपिटल बोलते हैं तो अपना ही लाया हुआ पैसा वो विड्रॉ कर रहा है तो ड्रॉइंग्स हमेशा कैपिटल में से माइनस होते हैं क्योंकि ड्रॉइंग्स की वजह से कैपिटल का जो बैलेंस होता है वो बिजनेस में कम हो जाता है. Okay, we move to the next entry. Yes, so Simran, you were solving this entry. Just tell what will be the two effects.
Ma'am, I'm minus 800 from the furniture because it depreciated.
Yes.
And minus 800 from the capital.
Okay, because this is an expense for the business.
Business.
Okay, so on the asset side, you reduce furniture by 800 because the value of furniture has depreciated. And on the right hand side, under capital, you reduce it by 800 again because the depreciation is an expense for the business. Okay, you can please keep tallying the balances at every step. Yes, Sakshi.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Sakshi, beta, next entry ka batao.
Ma'am, in this entry, sales of good will be sold at 15,000. So the goods will be deducted by 15,000. And for 18,000, it will be on credit basis. So the debtors will be increased by 18,000.
Okay.
And it is a profit for business for 3,000. So it will be added in capital for 3,000.
Very good. the three effects of the entry are there on your screens. Goods and debtors on the left hand side, on the asset side, and then profit is added to capital account. गुड्स जो बिजनेस से बाहर जा रहे हैं वो 15,000 के हैं, पर आपने बेचे 18,000 में है, सो फर्स्ट 3,000 ऑफ प्रॉफिट फॉर द बिजनेस, बट यू हैव नॉट रिसीव्ड एनी कैश. दीज गुड्स हैव बीन सोल्ड ऑन क्रेडिट, सो यू आर एडिंग डेटर्स टू द बिजनेस टू द ट्यून ऑफ रुपीज 18,000. ओके, एंड लेट्स मूव टू द लास्ट एंट्री. Yes, Aryaman is here. Aryaman.
Ma'am, Aryan.
Okay, Aryan, you can.
Ma'am, rent due to landlord 2000. Ma'am, rent account debit to outstanding rent. So, ma'am, ma'am, capital se ma'am 2000 kam ho jayega aur rent pe plus ho jayega. Outstanding rent.
Outstanding. बेटा आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंसेस में हम अभी आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंसेस में ही कर लेते हैं इसकी एडजस्टमेंट. ठीक है, तो वहां पे 2000 ऐड हो गया एंड यस कैपिटल में से आप 2000 माइनस कर लोगे क्योंकि दिस इज अगेन एन एक्सपेंस फॉर द बिजनेस. ओके, सो आई होप ऑल द एंट्रीज आर क्लियर. One last step what you people will do here is that on basis of all the balances you get here, the final balances of all the accounts. Is there some question? Yes, Suraj. Please ask Suraj, kya puch rahe ho aap? ओके, माइट बी देयर सम नेटवर्क इशू. हाँ जी बोलो बेटा.
आरएचएस साइड में ही ना कट होगा
क्या चीज? दोबारा पूछो. 15th एंट्री का पूछ रहे हो? आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंस बेटा लायबिलिटी होता है.
मैम ये पूछ रहा हूँ कोई क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 में सिर्फ आरएच साइड में ही इफेक्ट होगा ना?
हाँ हाँ, दोनों इफेक्ट राइट हैंड साइड पे.
या एक लायबिलिटीज प्लस हो जाएगा और फिर कैपिटल में माइनस हो जाएगा.
कैपिटल में से माइनस होगा. हाँ जी.
ओके मैम.
ओके, सो व्हाट आई एम आस्किंग आफ्टर दिस इज दैट यू प्रिपेयर द बैलेंस शीट. बैलेंस शीट के लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पे लायबिलिटीज प्लस कैपिटल वाला पूरी अमाउंट आएगी. और राइट हैंड साइड पे सारे एसेट्स आ जाएंगे एंड यू हैव टू शो इन दिस वर्टिकल फॉर्मेट. सो दिस इज अ हॉरिजॉन्टल फॉर्मेट, सॉरी, नाउ वी आर फॉलोइंग द वर्टिकल फॉर्मेट. सो इन दिस फॉर्मेट यू हैव टू शो दैट बोथ द साइड्स टैली. And you, when you start the liabilities side, you started with the amount of capital. और उसके बाद आपकी जो भी liabilities हैं वो आप यहाँ पे balances लिखोगे, उसी तरह assets के balances लिखोगे. And tell me what is the total coming to on both the sides. यस वंदन
मैम, एक बार
बैलेंस शीट में लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पे सारी लायबिलिटीज आएंगी जो आपकी इक्वेशन में थी. जो आपका राइट हैंड साइड ऑफ इक्वेशन था वो सारी लायबिलिटीज आप यहाँ पे लिखोगे. कैपिटल था, उसके बाद आपके क्रेडिटर्स तो जीरो हो गए थे ना, उसके बाद आई थिंक आपके आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंसेस थे. And then on the asset side, you had furniture. then you had debtors.
Ma'am, we have to write the impact or the final value.
Final amount. जो last okay. chapter के बाद जो balances यहाँ पे आए हैं ना वो आपने लिखने हैं.
Okay.
ठीक है फिर आपके पास cash in hand, cash at bank and आपके पास goods की जगह अब आप यहाँ पे लिख दो stock. ये सब बैलेंसेस आप लिखो. इफ देयर इज एनी अदर वैल्यू जस्ट चेक. क्रेडिटर्स की अमाउंट अभी है बिजनेस में या नहीं है वो चेक कर लेना.
मैम
यस आई एम बोलो
मैम. क्रेडिटर तो मैम जीरो हो गए थे तो उसको लिखेंगे नहीं मैम लायबिलिटीज में.
नहीं नहीं फिर जीरो वाले को नहीं लिखेंगे. चेक कर लेना कोई अमाउंट बची तो नहीं है.
ओके मैम.
ओके इट जीरो अमाउंट वोंट बी रिटन.
मैम ऐसे करके लेफ्ट हैंड साइड और राइट हैंड साइड इक्वल करनी है हमें लास्ट में.
हां जी हां जी.
मैम ऐसे क्वेश्चंस और कहां से प्रैक्टिस कर सकते हैं मैम जैसे.
मैं भी एक क्वेश्चन आपको और दूंगी प्रैक्टिस के लिए. ओके एंड देन आई विल शेयर मोर क्वेश्चंस आल्सो. So you can practice over the weekend. Be clear with this because aage jo a question on accounting equation won't be coming in the paper. But this is the basis on which we'll be doing the journal entries aur aage jo bhi subsequent topics hain wo is basis pe karenge. To aapko ye clear hona chahiye. I'll share more questions with you on the Google Classroom. Okay. Yes, Simran.
Ma'am, we will only write the balances now.
Yeah, the final balances.
Okay.
Ma'am, WhatsApp पे share कर दोगे ma'am? Ma'am, group में ma'am.
Group पे भी कर दूंगी. क्यों क्या हुआ? Classroom में नहीं हो added?
Ma'am, है ma'am, लेकिन मैं उस थोड़े से थोड़े समझने में ma'am दिक्कत होती है ma'am. WhatsApp में ma'am थोड़ा सही हो जाता है.
बेटा थोड़ा formal पे आ जाओ. जो प्रोसीजर फॉलो होगा व्हाट्सएप इज टोटली इनफॉर्मल कम्युनिकेशन. आई विल शेयर ऑन व्हाट्सएप आल्सो बट एक्सेस ट्राई एक्सेसिंग क्लासरूम आल्सो बिकॉज़ ऑल द असाइनमेंट्स व्हिच विल बी गेटिंग इन फ्यूचर विल बी ऑन गूगल क्लासरूम. थोड़ी हैबिट डालो यूज करने की.
यस मैम.
Okay, so just tell me what is the total coming to, क्योंकि वो तो आपका टैली हो ही रहे होंगे balances. किस amount पे टैली हो रहा है? Okay, कार्तिके 2,05,100. Okay, if you people see, then there is a double line. When I have given the total, this is what is followed. Whenever we give the final total, underneath the total, it is a double line, which signifies that this is the total of all the above values. Okay. Aryaman, you have made some mistake. What we'll do is we'll write the individual balances. You just tally kuch beech mein plus minus ka difference hua hoga. But this is the final total. So even better, I'll share the solution to this question on WhatsApp. Okay. So aap log udhar tally kar lena ek bari. Sirf kahin pe totaling mein hi aapki mistake hui hogi. Okay, so one more question I am sharing on accounting equation. So this is from your CBSE book 11th. There are around 10 entries in this. So just start with the question. Wahi format hai. Assets equal to liabilities plus capital. और जो first column होता है वो हमेशा एंट्री की नरेशन होती है. सो यू कैन राइट डाउन सिंपली ट्रांजैक्शन हियर एंड यू कैन स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट एंट्री कमेंस्ड बिजनेस विद कैश. तो ट्रांजैक्शन में ये पूरी स्टेटमेंट आप लिखोगे और फिर एसेट्स के अंदर कैश एंटर करके एंड यू स्टार्ट राइटिंग द बैलेंसेस. Okay, so start with the question. Any doubt, any query, just ask me.